All right, guys, we're in the shop. We got a YouTube request to do the oil seals on a 5CP pump. So I got a 5CP here, got a couple oil seals, a couple hand tools. We're gonna get this thing opened up and we're gonna show you how to change out that oil seal. So let's get into it right away. I got a 6mm Allen wrench. First thing I'm gonna do is loosen and take out these 8 bolts that are holding the head on. So let me crack all these loose here quick. Again, if you guys have any requests for videos, put them in the comments and I will do my best to make a video on whatever issues you guys are having at your car washes or whatever questions you're having at your car washes. That's how this video came to be, so don't forget that. Leave it in the comments and we'll get it done for you. All right, so I have the 8 head bolts out. I'm gonna set them to the side. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna slide one of these end caps off. If you had a pulley on here, you could just use the pulley to do it. If you just have the bare shaft, you can just grab an adjustable wrench, get onto that keyway, give it one full turn till the head pops out a little bit. The head will separate from the back end of the pump. At this point, I'm just gonna take my pry bar, my smaller pry bar, and just gently wiggle that out till I feel like I can get my paws on it and pull it off. Just like that. I'm gonna set that head to the side. And now we're gonna get into getting to the oil seals. So I am going to change this seal here on our left. I have a 10mm wrench. I'm gonna spin this shaft again just to get that plunger out in front of the center plunger just to make it easier to take the bolt out. So a 10mm wrench. Just gonna spin this around to make it easier on me. Give that a little wiggle. I'm gonna get the ceramic, the bolt, and my small washer off all at the same time. I'm gonna set that to the side. Okay, so now we're inside of the back end of the pump. I'm gonna pull the retainer out, the split washer, and then the slinging washer. Set those to the side. I like to set them in order, in that order that I took them out, so I know what order to put them back in. It's always a good idea when you take something apart to lay it out in front of you in the order you've taken it apart so that you can just reverse that and put it back together in the same order. That way you don't get anything mixed up. All right, guys, so I've turned the shaft so that the crankshaft push rod is back seated inside of the oil seal, creating a lip gap so that I can get a precision screwdriver, is what I use, back in there. And what I'm gonna do is just wiggle that in between the two, put a little pressure and give it a twist like I'm turning a screw. I'm gonna do that in a couple spots and that's gonna give me that oil seal out. Now that I have the oil seal out, I'm just gonna give it a quick inspection, make sure everything looks clean. I don't have any debris. If you see metal buildup, any shavings or anything like that, the back end of your pump is probably to the point that you should just replace the entire pump itself, not worry about doing the oil seals. If something back here is grinding that much, presenting shavings, we're already at a point of replacement instead of fixing. So I got my new oil seal out. What I like to do is take just a little WD-40, spray over that. All I'm doing with that is lubing up the rubber to make it easier for me to slide in to the seating area for that seal. So I'm gonna get it started with my fingers here and just get it kind of flat and evened out. I have a 15/16 socket. If you don't have a 15/16, a 3/4, something like that will work. And what we're doing is we're taking the edge of the socket, using the socket to push the seal back in flat against its resting area to keep the oil in the back end of this pump. So I'm just gonna take that socket, get it lined up, give it a firm push, a visual inspection that it's in flat and everything looks good. All right, guys, we got the oil seal replaced. We're gonna reverse that layout that we had. When we took it apart, we laid our parts out to make our lives easier. We're just gonna reverse that now. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna rotate this crankshaft again to push that push rod out, and I'm gonna start to rebuild. Got my slinger washer. Ooh. See, I laid it out and I started to do that wrong already. Got my slinger washer, split washer. Now I'm gonna get my ceramic plunger back in. Guys, if you're rebuilding this at that point, you're probably gonna wanna replace that rubber O-ring. This pump doesn't need a new rubber O-ring, so I'm just going straight back in with what we got. Start to get that hand. Start that bolt by hand. I'm gonna turn it around. I'm just gonna spin that back in. Oh, even I dropped tools. Now look, we wanna make sure they're tight, but we don't need to send them home. We don't need to break anything. Okay, I got that tight. So we got the oil seal replaced. All we need to do here yet is get our head back on. So I typically like to straighten these out as much as I can. Line up your seals with the plungers, get them started, and then in a rocking motion, you can slip those seals back over the push, over the plungers. We can put this pump back in service, or we can get it on the shelf so we have a backup. If you guys have any questions about cap pumps, seals, or anything else about your car wash, give us a call at Kleen-Rite and we'll get you fixed up.
Kleen-Rite.